Greetings, my name is CJ from TCC. You may remember me from such videos as the TeamSpeak tutorial and the Game Server tutorial. Today we're going to take a trip through the Mani tutorial. What is it? How to get it? How to install it on your system? And how to control it? This tutorial is mainly for Valve-based games such as Counter-Strike, Day of Defeat, and hopefully Team Fortress 2, and others. If you don't have a server, then consider Art of War Central. They are really top-notch when it comes to game servers and dedicated boxes. Let's kick things off by looking at how Mani is installed on your Art of War Central server. Okay, so what is the Mani Admin plugin? It's a plugin which is installed on your server to allow you to administrate your server better. It does this by presenting you with a feature-rich set of tools in the form of a menu system. Firstly, you will need to navigate to control.artofwarcentral.com in your browser, and then you will be shown a page which looks similar to this. Okay, if we zoom in, we can actually see that you need to enter your username and password, so we'll go ahead and do this. Click on the Remember Me button, and then click on Login, and it will change to Processing, and you'll see that you'll begin the login process. Once you're logged in, you'll get a screen which looks like this, or similar to it, and we're after the Gaming Services icon, and it looks like a picture of a little joystick. So if you click on that, you'll be presented with a screen that looks like this, which details all of your servers, and we're after the Counter-Strike Source server, or our Counter-Strike Source server, and all you got to do is click on it. Next page will pop up, and it will detail your server, the connection info, the FTP, your status, whether it's running or stopped, and what action you can do to that server, stop it and restart it. And we're looking for the game mods icon, which looks like two little joysticks. So click on that. Okay, you'll be presented with a screen that looks like this. And here you can see we've had no last mods installed. And these are all the mods that we can install. And if we click on one, mainly the Mani Admin plugin, we click on that, it will give us some instructions in the comments section, telling us that if we install it, you're going to overwrite it. Okay, if we click on install, we get a pop-up box which says the game server will be stopped so that the mod can be installed. Do you want to continue? If we click on OK, that will go off and install, and you'll see that you're going to message up afterwards. It says your mod's going to be installed, and basically you'll receive an email when it has been completed. So we click back. Okay, you'll see that the server has now been stopped. You can start it, but I don't think the mod is actually installed, so we'll just leave it for now. Obviously, when you come back in, when it's all installed, the server will be running again. You won't have to do anything. That is basically how you install your Mani Admin plugin to your server. Okay, so what is the Quake Sounds mod? Well, the Quake Sounds mod is a plugin for Mani Admin, and you plug it in and basically gives you the Quake Sounds. So in order to install it, we first have to log in, so we'll just type in our username and password, click on Remember Me, and log in. Okay, now we have to click on the Gaming Services icon, which looks like a picture of a little joystick, so click on that. When we do that, we get up a page with the list of our servers, and we're looking for our Counter-Strike server. Notice that we've installed the Mani Admin plugin already from the previous section, and now we're looking for the game mods icon. So we've clicked on the server, now we look for the game mods icon, click on that, and you get presented with your list again. We're after the Quake Sounds mod, so we click on that. Yeah, Manny Quake Sounds. So those are the Manny Quake Sounds. It says install the Manny admin plugin, Quake Sounds add-on pack. Note, requires the owner to add plus XE blah 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 in his manny server.cfg file. So we click on install, and it says the game server will be stopped. Once you click on OK, then you'll be brought to another page which basically tells you that the game server is going to be stopped and the mod is going to be installed, and then you'll receive an email when the mod is installed and your server will be restarted. Okay, so hopefully you've now got it up and running, the Quake Sounds, and first thing we've got to do is go into the file manager. So we click on the file manager icon, zoom in a bit, click on it, and you're presented with a screen that looks like this, and we're after the, you'll see directories and files in this sort of layer, and we're looking for the C-Strike folder. So if we click on that, then you'll be taken to a screen which looks like this. And you'll see files and folders in here again, and we're looking for a folder this time called CFG. So we click on the CFG folder. Okay, and then you'll be presented with folders and files again, and we're looking for the manny server.cfg file, and we want to edit this file. So we go across to a box, and inside that box is rename and edit, and you click on edit, and you'll be presented with it go off and load another page, and you'll be presented with a screen that looks like this, which looks like a simple little text editor. So all we've got to do here is add our line that we were told to add before, which is plus XE, EXEC, Manny underscore Quake underscore Sounds dot CFG, and then we just click on save. Okay, then it say processing, and then if you look right at the top of the page, you'll see the file has been saved. Now find your Manny underscore Quake underscore Sounds.cfg file, which should be in your C-Strike slash CFG folder, or click the back button. Now click on edit on the left hand side to bring up the editor, and then replace Manny underscore Quake underscore Sounds 0 with Manny underscore Quake underscore Sounds 1. And save the file. And all that's left is to turn it on inside the game. Okay, I've just got one more thing to add, and that's just to restart your server after you made all those changes. And that's it for part one. And in part two, we should be discussing how to add admins to Manny, how to use the Manny in game, how to use Manny Archon in game, and how to install plugins to Manny. However, that's all we've got time for. So hopefully, I'll catch you in part two.